2001 Odyssey Disco. This feels so fucking great. I mean, just standing here on the stage, here in the very building where John Travolta filmed Saturday Night Fever. I know he was here, I can still smell him.
That Brooklyn is a disco capital of the world. We'd like to make Brooklyn the rock capital of the world.
I don't think they ever had a fucking crowd like this here, you know. Oh, I see everybody's got some records, huh? You got some records? Listen, we got two shows for you tonight, and what we're going to do tonight, we're going to hold these. Because next set, we got a whole pile of albums. So if you got any albums or anything you want to smash, next set, we're going to be doing all that smashing shit. Okay, so you hang around. Fatty won't take these. Put them in the toilet bowl where they belong, you know what I'm saying? That's what we're about to keep them preserved in a good condition, you know what I mean? So, anyway, I'm fucking, turn the lights on these motherfuckers, let me get a look at this shit. I thought they said it was all disco assholes in Brooklyn, wait a minute. That must have been a mistake. I don't understand how you allow disco to take over. Looks like you motherfuckers keep the shit out of anybody, you know what I'm saying? You got something right there.
You know what? They told us that this was the biggest advance sale.
Yeah, disco sucks, but not like that right there. That's so nice.
They told us it was the biggest advance sale in the history of the 2001, including when the Tramps played here. Now, I have a feeling the song Disco Inferno may mean a little bit more than we all thought, but just would like to tell you this evening that the 2001 Club is turning all rock and roll, and the promoters tonight, they were kind of uptight, you know what I mean? Because they were afraid there was going to be nothing left of this palace. We told them, I'll tell you what, you just make sure this place is a rock and roll room and they'll leave it all right. Because if this place ever went back to being a disco, I think they'd blow this fucker up tonight. You know what I'm talking about? So I understand they're keeping it rock and roll, so let's keep it that way. And by the way, can we have a round of applause, please?
Twisted Sister rock solid.
Oh, yeah, you know, I feel like I'm in a shit state. Can we have one round of applause for the opening band? What the name was? Fallout.
Twisted fucking Sister rocks Brooklyn. Sick motherfucking friends of Twisted Sister, I think I said.
Friends of Brooklyn is what we got here.
Oh yeah, is that right? Okay. Alright, we can't waste no more time. We gotta get down to it. Cause a lot of motherfuckers. This one seems only appropriate because, you know, Brooklyn's been down so long and the 2001's been down so long that we think it's time to kick this shit right off on the start, alright? This one by Rainbow Cole, Long Live Rock and Roll!
Yeah.
sure their friends get through with this place. They ain't gonna have no more rock and roll bands here, you know what I'm saying? So baby, it's a Wednesday night. But it feels like Christmas to me. Cause playing the 2001 disco is like a fucking Christmas present, you know what I'm saying? Snakes take. SS and Record World. Crazy Eddie's got it. Now if you go to the store, they ain't got our single. That's because the first shipment sold out in like 2 days, like that. So they're shipping, thank you people of one. So they're shipping a bunch more, it'll be coming in any day. Plus we got our old single, I don't know if any of you heard about it. Called Never Grow Up Now, on the flip side was Under the Blade. A few of you may, that one's still in the stores, we can get that one later, right?
Twisted Sister, Fuck the Recession series of concerts. The first let me see if I get this right. The first one we did was down at the Fountain Casino in New Jersey.
New Jersey. We got anybody from New Jersey here? This is great. A meeting of the minds.
We played down at the Fountain Casino. 4,000 people showed up. The next one we played was out at Stony Brook, Long Island in Suffolk County. 2,000 people showed up. Now, the co-owner wouldn't let us do one here because he's a cheap motherfucker. But next week at Speaks, we'll do the Nassau County Freebie.
Is that on, Joe? Is that definite?
Is that definite? It better be fucking definite. It ain't definite.
It's not definite.
That motherfucker's a cheap bastard, too. But we're going to try to
work it on it.
We're working on it. We're trying to bring you a couple of freebies or something because we know that money's tight. But I'll tell you, if you really want to know where we're going to be and what we're doing, besides the fact that we have got calendar cards to let you know, we've got an organization that they can tell you about this.
Yeah, okay, listen, motherfucker. I'll tell you right now, it goes like this.
First of all, we got our friends here tonight.
We're our friends. Where are they?
All right, see, the reason I asked that is because when you have an event like Twisted Sister, the saviors of rock and roll, band been putting down disco for 4 fucking years, when they get a chance to play, where are we then? Oh, 2001 Disco. That's an event. So you get all sorts of people, tourists, come down. They want to see what happens, you know. They want to see if I get crazy and do anything nuts, you know. And we're not nuts. We're pretty calm, you know. They want to say, they think like I want to take my mic stand and go like, dude. No, I won't do that. I won't do that because I'm not here for your entertainment. Sorry, I'm not going to respect my mic. So what we did is we started an organization, rather than calling it the Twisted Sister Fan Club, because that sounds like pussy shit, you know what I'm saying? I'm a Twisted Sister fan, oh, y'all. Yeah. Right, that's bullshit. We call it the Sick Motherfucking Friends of Twisted Sister. It's no lying, straight, no bullshit, okay, so pussies go home. Anyway, so we've got this organization, and the main thing we do is we deal drugs. That we inform our people where we're going to be playing, what's happening, when we got a new record out, when we'll be doing these free concerts. But we're putting together on August 25th, we're going to have an end of summer party exclusively for Sick Motherfucking Friends only, and it's going to be absolutely free. And it's going to start 11 a.m. in the morning, and it's going to finish 4 a.m. the next morning. We're trying to get like 3 or 4 bands, and there'll be a lot of shit going on. And that's going to be on August 25th. And all you got to do to get invited is to sign up with the Sick Motherfucking Friends. Now, I don't know where Linda, lovely Linda's going to be. You're going to be down the front. Coat check?
You're going to walk around. There'll be a chick walking around about this tall. She's a dwarf. But don't kick her. Just ask her to hand you a card and write your name and your address on it. That's all you got to do, and you'll be invited. Now, a lot of people here are brain damaged, I realize. I see a few. I can't write. I lost that ability months ago, you know what I'm saying? It's from rolling too many joints. My fingers were all fucked up, you know? It's called, what do you call that again?
It's called muscular twistrophy.
Oh, muscular, I got
it. That's why you roll so many joints, your thumbs get cramps. How many people ever get that fucking thing?
I got it.
Muscular twistrophy is a terrible disease. The only way you can recuperate is by taking 4 grams of coke a day for 3 years straight.
Yeah. Now, on account of that guy that I have to roll with my feet, I still get high, but the joint stinks. So, anyway, so when you got to sign up with this chick, and you'll find out we're playing. Plus, we got hotline cards. I don't know where those are going to be. They look like this. I'm well informed. My road manager's doing his job again. You see, I have cards right here. Is there a sign up there? No sign, okay? They go like this. It says Twisted Sister right there. It's got a calendar. Got a hotline number at the very bottom. There's a number of the nearest free VD clinic for some of our fans who need that stuff, especially after tonight after I fuck a few. Okay, so that's down the bottom. You can get those two. Honey, you better get one of these cards. You're going to need it after I'm through with you. Okay, so anyway. We got another show. Like I said, we got a whole pile of fucking albums. We're going to do them up next set. You know what I'm saying? I mean, this is glorious. I want you all to hang around. Don't no one go no place, because we're fucking going to do it tonight. You know what? Let's keep on rocking and rocking and rocking. Brooklyn's never going to be the fucking same after we get through it. I'll tell you that.
check this out.
Oh!
pants, you know what I'm saying? Seems to me that when I ask if you want to hear a little more, you've been shouting your fucking ass off, you know what I'm saying? So I ask you, you want to hear a little more? There's some people standing around in the back, I'm asking you too, you know what I'm saying? Which I ain't talking about normal rock and roll. I'm talking about sick motherfucking rock and roll, you know what I'm saying? Home, shoot that fucking skag, get down and get fucking naked, piss on the floor, rock and roll. Now when I ask you, you want to hear some high speed, sick motherfucking rock and roll?
And then Elvis Presley
Saturday Night Fever was made. And all of a sudden, the world, according to all the newspapers, went disco crazy. Everybody was in discos, and rock and roll was dead. But here was little old Twisted Sister in Long Island, and we were jumping up and down with cold Heinekens in our hand, screaming, "You gotta be fucking kidding! Ain't no way fucking bullshit disco is gonna wipe out 25 fucking years of rock and roll!" 1977, 1978, 1979, all of a sudden all the bands started to wake up from their sleep, and what you got now in 1980 is the biggest surge of a heavy metal rock and roll ever seen on the planet Earth. And this all goes by way of saying that we don't care what people say. Rock and roll is here to stay. I want you to sing along with us right now. Just watch me and D here. Dig this. Well, we don't care what the people say. Rock and roll is here to stay. No, we don't care what the people say. Rock and roll is here to stay. No, we don't care what the people say.
I see 50% singing, and the other 50% standing around like a bunch of clowns. No, well, I think we got a lot of tourists here, you know what I'm saying? I'm sitting down on the side. Hi, yes, you saw Twisted Sister and lived. Aren't you excited? But motherfucker, maybe you just don't realize how important this event is. I mean, I doubt very strongly that there's too many disco people here, because I think they're too afraid of getting their ass kicked in, you know what I'm saying? When we came here today, we were scrounging around in the back room, and you won't believe what we found. Eddie or Jay, will you move out of the way a second? Just bring this out, my boy.
We dug this thing up, guys, get down a little bit. We dug this sign up here. This sign was the original sign. Now, I'll turn all the lights on. This sign was the original sign used when they made all the posters for Saturday Night Fever. Well, so is it. Let's give it a salute, ladies and gentlemen.
Hey, it's time to ring out the old and bring in the new. Because we got something to say about that.
company, you know? Sounds like while we took a break, everybody got a little quieted down after it took so. As we had such a good time getting you back up. Are you mellow? Are you feeling all right right now? Because we ain't about to stop this evening, so it's okay. You want to lean back and get mellow?
I'm mellow, but motherfucker, don't you realize? Don't you know that these people here are the sickest diehard rock and rollers there are? You know what I'm talking about? I'm amazed. No, the Foo Fish, don't you?
What is that?
I mean, these monitors sound like fucking dog shit. You know what I'm saying, Fatty Rip? I mean, it's Wednesday night. Tomorrow's school. Tomorrow, people gotta go to work. And turn the lights on, these motherfuckers. Let me get a look at this shit right here. Hey, see this shit? There were not that many, but there were some old people here before. But they went home, because they had to get up early tomorrow, and they were tired. And don't we feel fucking sorry for them, you know what I'm talking about? Rather dead than disco, you ain't fucking kidding. But then you got these motherfuckers, they say, fuck school, fuck work, I'm hanging out, get fucked up, you know what I'm talking about? This is the kind of people we like.
It got to me because I just remember the club owner walked in and told me that we broke the attendance record here in 2001 this evening. And that's thanks to you people that we broke the attendance record. Now, the guy told us, he came in here, he said, you know, I had my doubts whether or not I was going to turn this.
Where are we? We're in a case. Just keep going, pretend nothing's wrong.
They had it, yeah.
All the time, back's bad, he turned it way down.
He had his doubts about what he was going to do as far as rock and roll, but he told us tonight, he walked in and he said, that's it. You fucking guys proved it to us tonight. We are going 100% rock and roll as of tonight here in 2000. So, that means we ain't going to trade out this beautiful place. But all I got to tell the guy is, for his own good, that if he wants to make this place a rock and roll room, he should make it a rock and roll looking room and not a fucking thing that looks like you're on the inside of a Swanson TV dinner.
Did you tell her that the club owner has decided, after seeing how many of you motherfuckers came down tonight, to go 100% rock and roll? That is the word that I hear. That means that the disco people, disco assholes of Brooklyn, won't have the 2001 to kick around no more. Taste tells. He took one look at our clientele and said, this is the kind of sick people that I want to have in my club. Not these disco dildos with their three-piece suits and their dicks tucked in their ass. You know what I'm saying? No, she knows what I'm saying. She really... Shit. Stop.
I'm fucking cranky tonight, man.
They're cranky, all right. That's what your lady said. I want to dedicate this one to somebody, right? It says, please say goodbye to me. I'm going to Colorado tomorrow. And they signed a name. Is that you, honey? I'll say goodbye to you on the side of the stage. No, I'm okay. No, I'm going to do this one for you. This one, hey, for people who don't know, we do our own material. We have a lot of our own stuff. When we play concerts, like the Palladium and stuff like that, we do all originals. When we play the clubs, there's people. I mean, we love bands like Judas Priest and AC/DC and stuff. And we feel that the people don't get to hear enough good heavy metal. So we play other people's stuff in the clubs. But we drive our own stuff. We'd like to do this one for you. Eddie, are you all right, my man? You should be on the stage. Everybody ready? Thank you.
Yeah.
right now. I told you before the last night of the club owner, I said, just do one show. We said, no, two shows. I said, we don't really start cooking until later tonight. We're cooking right now. There's a lot of things we got to get off our chest. We'd like you to realize, man, that this is like a whole gold mine for us coming down here. We would like to somehow make sure that you people come and see us other times, because I'm telling you, this is the kind of thing we're talking about, man. It's like what it's like doing is all the rock and rollers and all the five boroughs of Long Island, New Jersey, all got to get together in Connecticut and really fucking ram it home, man. Not enough rock and roll bands are coming out of the New York State area and doing it. It's about fucking time, and Twisted Sister is going to be the one to do it. You understand? Call us up. Even if you can't make it down, call the number. We tell you dirty jokes over the air. And you can tell your friends where we're going to be to make it down, because we want to see you people down so much more. I tell you, we love playing. And we did an outdoor concert last year. 23,000 people showed up in this little amusement park. This year,
23,000?
Yeah, 20,000.
Sorry, I missed that.
Yeah, well, you missed it. That's because you were so fucked up, you didn't know where the fuck you were. But
this year, I will know where I am.
All right, but this year, we're trying to get Aqueduct Raceway to let us do the concert.
Because when the Good Rats played Belmont Lake, some people in the audience fucked a couple of the mayors. I don't know, there's no accounting for some people's taste. I mean, they're a real horse face, but that is why, fucking with the horses, that's why they won't have to act with us.
So the Good Rats did this thing now, so what are we all left with now? We're left with having to play all these rooms, trying to get these people to come down. And you know, when you're in a room like this, especially 2001, because every time I drove here in Brooklyn, my car refused to come down the street because the word said disco on the fucking, up on the marquee. But now that we're here tonight, there's something that we haven't done in a long time, and I think we're just going to do it for old time's sake. You know, we've done a bunch of things this evening we haven't done in a while, and I think it's just so fitting for the evening. So don't sing along, I'll be appreciated.
This goes way, way back to original words to this. Song again, being that we're here at the 2001 disco, it's so fucking intense. We had to bring back songs like Chinese Hustle, we stopped doing because it was anti-disco and disco's fucking big. And this song we stopped doing a long time ago. We even changed the words to rock and roll saviors, because disco's fucking over. It's done with kick-ass rock and roll as the fucking clown once more. You know what I'm talking about?
Well, I hate disco music, cause disco really sucks. I hate disco music, cause disco really sucks. Well,
people scream disco songs. We don't all, but there's something about screaming disco sucks in this room that will make me feel so good. So on the count of three, if you ever have wanted to scream it in your life, if you have ever been so fed up walking down King's Highway and hearing all that fucking disco music shit blasting out of everyone's fucking car and fucking rocket spot, if you're sick and tired of it and you're fucking happy that rock and roll is back and alive, please just give it to me one time. The words of disco sucks on count to three. I want to hear the loudest, fucking most sincere. I'm in the middle of fucking Brooklyn. I'm loud, I'm proud, I'm rock and roll scream. You got at the count of three. I hope you're ready. Don't disappoint me, because I want to remember this one for all time. Here we go.
Isn't it far out? Hey, no,
it's a short ass.
Yeah, really, man, wow, hey. Now, you disco people out there, I know you're out there somewhere. How do you like walking around a club and not having to worry what people think about your fucking haircut all the time? You know what I'm talking about? How do you like walking around when nobody gives a shit you got a white Monte Carlo in the parking lot? How do you like being someplace where they don't give a shit how good you can dance or how much you look like John Travolta, huh? Fucking where it's at, you should catch on to that real quick before you lose out, you know. There's a song by AC/DC called Rock and Roll Damnation, you know. And line goes, take a chance while you still got the choice, you know what I mean? You can either join us now or all the sick motherfuckers get together with Sister. We're gonna fucking take over, then you're gonna have to like me, you know what I'm saying? So, or else you'll be in jail or on acid or something. I don't know. I'm into fucking total. I don't know what I'm into, fucking, that's total rule, that's it.
They got the look, I want to know better. They got the look, all right, listen, folks, a couple of things.
Hey, I know, you know I pick up the disco people?
How's that?
They ain't tapping their feet, they're snapping their fingers.
Oh, I dig it, well, that's okay.
Hey, that's heavy, go ahead.
I smelled them too, man, there was enough Aramis to sink the Titanic, but that's besides the point. Hey, look, we do have a couple of things. We have the SMF Friends of Twisted Sister, that's a sick motherfucking friend. It's like a private little organization. You gotta sign up for it.
Sick motherfucking friends and Twisted Sister. There's a chick walking around. She's up there now. Her name's Linda. Just shout, hey, Linda, where the fuck are you? Get down and get naked, you know? And you can sign your name on a card. That's all you gotta do. And then you're a member of the sick motherfucking friends of Twisted Sister forever free, no charge. You'll get mailing lists. You'll get pictures. You'll get concert happenings, free concert happenings. You'll know everything in advance. You'll find out what kind of deodorant JJ French uses, what brand Scumbag Prophylactic Eddie O'Dea uses, you know, you'll find out secrets about Mortiano Mendoza, like he's the only person with a punch card to the free clinic, you know what I'm talking about? He fucking buys them by the dozen. He comes in every month, they're, oh, Mr. Mendoza, you showed up. What form of Vietnamese clap do you have this month, you know what I'm talking about? So anyway, so you find all that shit. Plus, at the end of the summer, August 25th, we have a free exclusive to SMF Friends only. Free end of summer party starts at 11 a.m. in the morning and finishes 4 a.m. the next morning. It's gonna be the sickest. Twisted Sister's gonna be there. And we're gonna get a lot of rock and roll bands. We've been talking to the Beatles and Led Zeppelin. We're seeing what we can do. We're working on putting a reunion together with them, but I don't know. But we're definitely, Pink Floyd is gonna be opening for us with only half of the wall because the small stage. Okay? So if you want to sign up for that, you sign up for that. We ran out of hotline cards.
There's one other thing too, you know, and that is we don't have t-shirts with the new logo on it. We were out, but we will be getting t-shirts, and for the SMF people, we're gonna have a special thing for you that you're gonna be getting in the mail. It's a little offer, real cheap. And I just want you to know, the money for the t-shirts goes to a very important organization. I just want you to listen. President Jimmy Carter has asked Twisted Sister to be the official band of the Summer Olympics. There's only one problem. We ain't fucking going to Russia. That's because the fucking Russians suck gorilla dick, you know? Besides that,
we suck bear dick.
Oh, I'm sorry, they suck money and they suck black men. But the point is that he asked us, he said, well, Twisted, if there's only gonna be, there's gonna be no Olympics over there in Russia, where the fuck are you gonna have the Olympics? We said, we wanna hold it at the Meadowlands, a giant stadium. He says, well, you're only gonna have one event. What is it? So we thought about it, and what we're gonna do is, we're gonna sponsor the Twisted Sister 5,000 meter coke run, ladies and gentlemen. Now, let me explain to you what the 5,000 meter coke run is.
have some interest now.
What you do is this, okay? We're gonna drop the largest mirror you ever saw on your life on the fucking field of fucking the Giant Stadium. This fucking mirror is about 9,000 acres square. Then, we're gonna have the helicopters lower an 18-ton rock of Peruvian flake cocaine.
Beautiful.
You do what I'm talking about, right?
Totally. It's like it's the potential rock.
Now, this fucking rock is giant. How the fuck you cut a rock like this? The biggest razor blade that Schick ever built.
Paul Bunyan's razor blade.
It's gonna be lowered down and we're gonna chop up 1,000 lines of fucking coke, 5,000 meters long and 4 inches thick.
Now, here's 4 inches thick.
If you're a member of the SNF Club, you get an official number, you get a skateboard, and a 9-foot silver tube. And the object of the run is not who can make it first, but who can make it alive. Now, how many people would like to be involved in the Twisted Sister Coke run?
Licking allowed. Licking is allowed.
All right, so if you want to be involved in this thing and other great stuff, don't forget to join the SNF Red Swissers and do what you can do. Call those hotline cars. And by the way, there's bartenders here. Do what you can do with them, too. I don't know. I hate for them to work in disco rooms anymore.
And remember, support VD. Nobody else does. So we try to mix them out as much as possible. Okay, we gotta finish up with this one. This is a little boogie, all right? This is a little boogie, okay? When, we did a lot of songs that we don't normally remember doing in a while, but what the fuck, you know? It's all not too often. We're retiring a lot of things, unless we get to play Studio 54 if they reopen and decide to go rock and roll. Then we'll play fucking, you know, the
Studio 54? Would you be willing to come to Studio 54 if we played it?
We'll fucking destroy that dog. This place is half destroyed already, so it doesn't matter, okay? So, okay, we'll do this one for us as one of our own. It's called High Stepping! Fucking all. And it's plain, it's easy to see. That boogieing is what rock and roll is all about, honey. And I don't care how many fucking disco dance hall bands scream that they boogie down and boogie in and boogie out, and they got up and boogie oogie oogie, and all the people telling you, I'm going out boogie this Friday and Saturday. Because all I can tell you is that from the first day it started to the day it dies, the only thing that disco does is bullshit to you. That's the truth, man. It's just a pile of fucking bullshit. It's a capitalistic plot to overthrow the government. Oh, no, that's another speech. That was my fucking third grade sociology speech. Okay, I got it. So, baby, when I ask you if you know what boogie it is, you definitely gotta know, because you're any kind of rock and roller. It's just that feeling you get when Ted Nugent comes blasting out at you. You know what I'm saying? Or Van Halen comes blasting out at you. Or Led Zeppelin comes blasting out at you. Or Twisted Sister comes blasting out at you. So check this out now. Go out there and do what the man. Tell you something, honey. Boogie is this thing, and I gotta get through to all the motherfuckers. Turn the lights on these people right here. I just gotta see right now. Who knows what boogie is? Where's the rest of your hands now? Hey, almost everybody knows. There's a few key people down here in front. Guys with their dicks, the girls are trying to impress them. See, that's one thing that boogie is not. Boogie is not having to impress all the idiots around you, you know what I'm saying? I mean, our friends don't give a shit what you look like. What you smell, well, if you smell it, I want you, but how much money you got, I don't care about nothing about that. All we care about is whether or not you love rock and roll and you love partying your ass off, you know what I'm saying? And if you dig rock and roll, then you're in that friend, you know what I'm saying, baby? And straight ahead, it's no bullshit. And it's the kind of thing that you don't gotta know anybody when you come down to a rock and roll club. You don't gotta, you come down all by yourself, and I know plenty of people who have one time or another, and you walk in, and the motherfuckers here, they ain't uptight. They have their own attitude about, hey, check her out, man. She's got fucking, you know, Dr. Scholl's sandals on, man. What kind of shit is that? You know, they don't give a shit. Down here, they look at you and say, hey, you by yourself? And they say, yeah. They say, you want to smoke a joint with us? And the friends say, yeah. And they pass around the joint and say, you want to get a couple of beers? We'll drink a little bit. And go outside, and before you know it, you're partying with everybody in your area. You know what I'm talking about? You know what I'm talking about, right? You know what I'm talking about? Rock and roll makes friends, and disco makes enemies. You know what I'm saying? If you don't believe that, just go to a disco sometime. Everybody's so hung up and fucked up, they can't even get out of their own shell and talk to you. You know what I'm saying? So now, I'm gonna book it for you, and I'm gonna explain it to you. You got to do it. And you can't say, well, I'm waiting for Friday night, and you can't say I got Saturday night fever no more. Because no sick motherfucker in his right mind waits for Saturday night. Every sick motherfucker knows the party is 7 days a week. Not stop! 365 days a year! So everybody, it's time to get down to boogie now! What the baby? That is something we've been waiting for all night! Something we ain't done in a long time. Oh yeah. Toast I like to make. An old toast goes like this. From the East Coast to the West Coast, Brooklyn to San Francisco, Twisted Sister did its best, and we wiped out fucking disco! Now, for the last nail in the coffin, as we bury the disco visage, will you please bring out the records, please? Hold it up, boys. Hold it up. Hold it. Can you hold it up? Come on. You're big. You're big. See, we have a little coffin made because we felt... Hold it. Oh, let it open up. Is it open? Okay. Because we felt that disco should have a proper burial. You know what I'm saying? So, put it down on the ground. Let's just go through some of these disco memories for a second while we have a chance. Okay, on the ground, very good. I love organization. Okay, now let's see what we got here. We got, I never heard of this one. I mean, disco is so much bullshit. These records are all like 99 cents. This is a band called Dynasty, and one. A band called Spool, but this one, it's the fucking one. This is the one that fucking started it all. And I got a word or two for this one in a few seconds. This one says, heavy metal in 1980, disco Choose the Load. And it's a medley of hits of 1979.
Yo, man, wait, I got a Chic album right here. They misspelled it. It ain't C-H-I-C, it's S-H-I-T. They misspelled it. By the way, put an error. I got an album here, it's called Rapper's Delight by Sugar Hill Gang. These motherfuckers don't know how to rap. These fucking guys don't know how to rap. If they want to rap, they come and see Twisted Sister, then they learn how to fucking rap, man. We got Ray Slim, a classic poster. KC, on Sunshine, man.
Go ahead, do one, man. Do one, Jay. I don't really know about them. Oh, here's one of the biggest sellouts. This is the Rolling Stones doing Miss You. I don't care for sellouts too much. I think Mick did too much acid, you know what I'm saying? So I may forgive him. The Spinners. We got the Beginners. We got Love Unlimited Orchestra with Barry White. We got Chic. We got Eddie Kendricks doing Boogie Down. We got Chic Savoir Faire. We got Donna Summer's Hot Stuff. We ain't done. It was originally called Disco World, where the music never stops, and they changed the title because they felt that there'd be too much flack having the word disco in the screenplay. What do you got there? We got the man! Wait a minute, we got something else, hold on.
Was and thought it was a joke. Let me tell you something, Mavis. We live our lives 100% rock and roll, and that's no lie. We bust our ass for rock and roll, and that's no lie. And there's one motto and there's one rule that we go by, and that's this. The future ain't shit, because you may not be here 20, 30, 40 years from now. But for those of you people who are so hung up about partying tonight, I want you to remember one thing. 40 years from now, your arthritis is going to be so bad that you're going to be lying in your bed and you're going to take arthritis pain formula, Bayer, Addison, and Excedrin, and you're going to get your crickly ass out of bed. You're going to go to the bathroom and you're going to put denture cream in your mouth and shove your dentures in your face. Then you're going to walk down to the kitchen and put oatmeal in your mouth because that's all you can fucking chew. Then you want to walk up to the bathroom and drink 20 bottles of KO Pectate. You're going to shit out little pellets and you're going to walk back to your bedroom. And at that point in time, you're going to say to yourself, why didn't I party on June 18th with Twisted Sister at the 2001 Disco in Brooklyn? I want to see those hands up in the air like this. I want to see everybody doing it. Give me those hands and celebrate the fact that you got it. Why you got it now already?
Well, are you ready to party tonight? I can hear you, baby. I say, well, are you ready to party tonight? Well, I ask you one more time, motherfucker. I don't ever see a person let you know it. I said,
throw your fist in the air, we'll know you agree with us. Let's go, boy!